30 years ago.
You can never predict, you know, how things are going to turn out.
We met Forrest Gump.
This is the picture of me and Tom Hanks.
Brought to life by the real people.
Are you crazy or just plain stupid?
I have one line. Are you running for the homeless?
And places.
Still one of the number one questions if you're here in Chippewa Square, where's the bench?
Of Savannah and the Lowcountry.
To be able to say, yes, I worked on Tom Hanks's movie, you know, Forrest Gump. I'm so proud of that.
You're watching Chronicle, Forrest Gump's 30-year run.
Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Shannon Royster.
And I'm Riley Miller.
30 years later, actor Gary Sinise is well remembered for playing the role of Lieutenant Dan in Forrest Gump. But prior to the film's release in 1994, he had only been in a couple of films.
Sinise said he never could have predicted what a huge success the film would be, or that playing a fictional character would go on to shape the rest of his life's work.
Buford and Forrest Gump, they kind of go together, and they have they both the movie and the town have a special place in my heart.
Still today, Forrest Gump has a major impact on Buford's tourism.
The visitors will come and they learn about and they take back to other people, and so when new people come, they want to see the sites where Forrest Gump was filmed.
Gary Sinise says 30 years ago, no one had any idea what a hit Forrest Gump would be.
We all knew that we were a part of something that had a lot of good things going for it, but you can never predict, you know, how things are going to turn out.
Sinise also had no idea playing a wounded veteran would have such a profound impact on his life.
The movie definitely had played a role, and certainly Lieutenant Dan played a role in helping to support what I ended up doing with all our veterans.
So what is it about Forrest Gump that makes the film so iconic? I asked both Tucker and Sinise.
It's about falling in love. It's about relationships. It's about friendships. And it has practically every emotion. And I think people on any level can identify with most of the parts of that movie.
I think a lot of people saw that movie when they were young. Now they've got their own kids and they're showing the movie to their own kids and passing it on. That's what makes a classic. You know, those classics get passed on because they're good and they survive and they live.
A chance encounter turned into a major career in film for one local woman. Laura Bryant told me her sister met the location manager for Forrest Gump while working at a rental car agency. Bryant had only worked on one film, but they needed help. So just like that, she was hired.
When the movie Forrest Gump came out in 1994, one local Savannahian can still remember how she felt all those years ago.
I was so proud of it.
Proud of her role in helping to bring the film to the big screen.
I was just in awe of what I was able to do. I think this is where the pinch was.
Meet Laura Bryant.
You talk to the production designer and the director and you get their idea what they're looking for. And then you try to go out and find it.
Assistant location manager for Forrest Gump.
Okay, we need X amount of houses. We need a football field. We need, a restaurant. We need an apartment where Jenny lives.
And it was a lot of hard work.
Oh my golly, it was crazy, crazy, crazy.
In order to bring the director's vision to life, she had to have a script.
I'd have this, read it and read it and read it and break it down.
She's held on to that script for 30 years.
It starts off white, but then every time they make a change, they give you a different color.
She also got to meet Forrest Gump himself.
I mean, that little bow tie, that little, you know, plaid shirt. We had three of those plaid shirts.
He stayed in character all day long.
So you really couldn't say, oh, Mr. Hanks, you know, so you just sort of let him do his thing.
16 hours a day.
He would get on a plane Friday night, do those running scenes on Saturday, fly back to either Buford or Savannah on Sunday to start filming again on Monday. He was incredible.
Working nonstop Monday through Friday.
That bus scene with Tom Hanks in the bench took 5 days.
He used cue cards for that location.
My sister came to visit that day on set, and she asked the guy who was holding the cue cards if she could have the first one. He goes, sure, here you go.
That following Christmas, Laura's sister gave her the cue card as a present.
I do hang this up in my office.
Those lines and opening scene stole the hearts of millions, solidifying the star power of Hanks and making Laura a sought-after location manager.
To be able to say, yes, I worked on Tom Hanks's movie, you know, Forrest Gump, I'm so, so proud of that. I truly, truly am.
Forrest Gump opened big doors for Bryant. She ended up working as a location manager on 32 additional films before retiring in 2022.
When Paramount came to Beaufort, it created a lot of opportunities for locals. And for Beaufort woman Catherine Scarborough, she had double duty. Scarborough was Sally Field's body double throughout filming, and her house was also used as a major part of the set.
This is the picture of me and Tom Hanks while we were filming the movie Forrest Gump, and I played Sally's double and stand-in. And I do have to say I had a fat suit on.
Scarborough says working closely alongside movie star Tom Hanks is something she will always cherish.
He could go into character immediately. You could be talking to him, and he could assume the Forrest Gump character immediately.
Scarborough recalls she had a lot of freedom during filming, and her vision for the school bus scene made it onto the big screen.
So I just leaned over and I grabbed his little chin. I said, "You remember, you're as good as anybody else." Sally came up. He said, "Watch her do this." And so that was my real addition.
Scarborough's house was also part of the movie. You may recognize it as Bubba's Mom's House.
This is how they told people to come to Bubba's Mama's house.
I guess 30 years ago, we didn't have GPS.
No, we did not.
Several scenes were filmed on this property.
When Tom Hanks visited Bubba's grave, it was right here. That's where that scene took place, where Forrest Gump jumped off the boat and the boat was running away and it ran into the dock. It was right there.
Other iconic scenes shot on the property include Forrest delivering Bubba's mom a check, where she faints on her porch. The hurricane scene with the television reporter was also shot on this lot.
They had a machine that would make it look fierce.
Scarborough says still today, visitors from all over the world show up at her house trying to catch a glimpse of movie history, and she's working to preserve it.
It's a special part of South Carolina.
It totally
and
is.
I think what's really unique about it and why they chose it is so many of our locations are getting redone. And this old house is just like an old house. It would have been here because it has been here probably 1920s.
To this day, Forrest Gump is impacting the lives of those who live in Savannah and Beaufort. And as WJCL 22 News' Brooke Butler reports, both cities continue to attract movie lovers. And that's great news for the local economy.
The blockbuster film Forrest Gump.
One of the main characters in that story is the city of Savannah.
Put coastal Georgia and the Lowcountry.
Most of the scenes are filmed in the Beaufort area.
Into the hearts of millions of people.
The star of the show happens to be the backdrop, you know, the natural beauty.
The movie portrays not just the beauty, but also the charm of this area.
We don't actually have that many scenes, but the scenes that are Savannah in that movie are absolutely iconic. They're very much something that Savannians can relate to because all of us will still sit on a bench and just sort of watch the world go by and people watch. It's a very Savannah thing.
It's those iconic scenes that have attracted visitors from all over.
You still see people talking about, asking where Jenny is, asking where her restaurant is, you know, where can we find this?
I think every tour, whether it's a carriage ride or a golf cart tour or even a walking tour, they're going to spend time telling the stories of Forrest Gump and what the impact of it, whether it's the bridge or a restaurant or his favorite box of chocolates. You're going to see that here in the local tours.
In Beaufort, they even have special Forrest Gump appearances at certain events.
Every shrimp festival is going to have a Forrest Gump impersonator show up and mingle about the crowd, or you're going to see it in the 5Ks, 10Ks events, kind of like our Run Forrest Run event that takes place during Shrimp Festival.
Some Beaufort restaurants even offer Forrest Gump themed menu items.
It's in recipes and on menu items. You're going to see Forrest's gumbo, which is a shout out to Bubba and his affinity to shrimp. And you're also going to see, Jenny's cocktails.
In Savannah, when the movie debuted, the city had 5 million visitors. In 2022, it was 22 million. So it's clear, even after 30 years, the story of Forrest Gump is still having a powerful impact on the local economy.
Tourism is still the number one output for this community. It has been for a long time, with $4.4 billion worth of spending last year. Mm-hmm. And if we look at where that came from, you can probably ask Forrest Gump.
Brooke Butler, WJCL 22 News.
Chippewa Square is known as the place where Forrest Gump once sat on a bench to wait for a bus. 30 years later, a replica of that iconic bench now sits in a local museum. Is it A, the SCAD Museum of Art, B, the Buford History Museum, or C, the Savannah History Museum? The answer when we return. Chippewa Square is known as the place where Forrest Gump once sat on a bench to wait for a bus. 30 years later, a replica of that iconic bench now sits in C, the Savannah History Museum.
One of the most famous scenes in the movie takes place right here in Chippewa Square, with Forrest Gump waiting on a bench for the bus. Historically, there were no benches in this square, so the studio had to build one, and now that bench has a new home.
When visiting the Savannah History Museum, for many tourists like Adrienne Steuben and her family, it's kind of like a box of chocolates. You just never know.
We didn't know the bench was here.
What you're gonna get.
So it was really cool to see and share with our kids.
Yep, she's talking about the bench Tom Hanks made famous in the movie Forrest Gump.
When Forrest Gump completed filming in 1994, this bench was gifted to the city of Savannah by Paramount Pictures.
And according to Emily Beck, director of interpretation for the Coastal Heritage Society, this area is a hot spot.
This is probably the most popular artifact in this museum, I think, especially for people who are just coming to the museum sight unseen.
Savannah City Councilman and bench historian Nick Palumbo says most people think it still sits in Chippewa Square.
It's still one of the number one questions if you're here in Chippewa Square that people are asking, where's the bench? And then you have to give them that heartbreaking news that we had to put it in a museum.
You might notice that we have a fence built around it now because so many people want to sit on it and have their picture made.
And they don't want it to break, especially since it's not an actual wood bench.
It is much bigger than you would think it would be. It's very long.
It's a prop made of fiberglass.
Fiberglass is much more easily damaged.
So if you go looking for the famous Forrest Gump bench, remember it's no longer in Chippewa Square, where General James Oglethorpe stands. It's nicely tucked away in the Savannah History Museum for those who have seen the classic and those yet to discover its magic.
So now my kids are probably about my age when it came out, so it would be fun to watch with them.
Marlena Smalls is known for her soulful Gullah performances, and her notoriety as a singer is what led her to play the role of Bubba's mom, Mrs. Blue. Forrest Gump fans all know the line, "Stupid is as stupid does," and it was delivered in response to Mrs. Blue's famous line.
Are you crazy or just plain stupid?
Although Forrest Gump was shot 30 years ago, Smalls remembers day one of filming.
It started out with me going to makeup.
That's where she recalls meeting Tom Hanks for the first time. It was early, around 5 a.m. Hanks was drinking his coffee and reading the paper. Starstruck, Small says she just froze.
He dropped the newspaper and he said, in the Forrest voice, he says, "Well, good morning, Bubba's mama," like that, you know. You broke the silence.
Smalls recalls her costume.
"Well, I'm just wearing a dress with an apron and the ugliest hat ever."
But what sticks out the most is filming the scene where she faints after receiving a large check from Forrest.
The mattress was here.
Was here, okay.
Mm-hmm. And so I fell like this. I had to go back.
With no body double, it proved to be a challenge.
I fell. I sort of squatted, you know? Mm-hmm. He said, "Marlene," he was real nice at first. He said, "Marlene, let's try it again." Cut! "Marlene, this is what I want you to do, honey. Would you just do such..." Cut! "Marlene, honey, fall!" I said, "What's wrong? Why can't you fall?" I said, "I don't have a slip on it."
After a few laughs on set, Smalls was finally able to nail her fainting scene in two takes. Smalls says she's so grateful for the movie experience and still collects royalties to this day.
Towards the end of the film, when Forrest Gump finally reunites with Jenny Curran, she is working at a historic restaurant in Savannah. Was it A, Clary's Cafe, B, Debbie's Restaurant, or C, Little Duck Diner? Stay tuned for the answer. Towards the end of the film, when Forrest Gump finally reunites with Jenny Curran, she is working at B, Debbie's, a historic eatery located on Bay Street here in Savannah. It has been around for more than 50 years.
For one low country man, his real life profession translated to the big screen. Juan Singleton was working as a television news reporter in Beaufort when he was assigned to cover a story on the movie being shot in town. After interviewing the film's producers and casting crew, they encouraged Singleton to attend an open casting call. And now, 30 years later, he's sure glad he did. Juan Singleton now works as the public information officer for the city of Hardeeville, but you may recognize him as Hannibal Reporter from the iconic bridge scene in Forrest Gump.
I had one line, and it was, "Are you running for the homeless?"
Singleton got the full Hollywood experience. He worked closely alongside the film's big star, Tom Hanks. He even had his own trailer with his name on it for the day. The scene he appears in is a short one, but he says it took 8 hours to shoot, and it included a few bloopers.
I flubbed it once. I made Tom Hanks laugh when I flubbed it. He was like, "What did you say?" And I just like, I don't even remember what I said, but.
While the sign in the movie labels the bridge Mississippi River, the scene was actually shot here on the Woods Memorial Bridge in Beaufort. Today, Singleton's small role is paying off as he still receives residuals.
I look at my check and I'm like, wow, if I'm getting this 30 years later, what do those stars make, you know?
Singleton says appearing in Forrest Gump gives him a whole new appreciation for the film industry. And it's a memory he will always cherish.
It really is one of my favorite movies, if not my favorite movie. And I'm not just saying that because I'm in it. It's really just a great movie. It's a feel-good movie that I think everybody likes and appreciates.
The filming of Forrest Gump took place all across the city of Savannah and the Lowcountry. This includes the war scenes set in Vietnam, which were actually filmed at a state park in South Carolina. Was it A, Colleton State Park? B, Hunting Island State Park, or C, Edisto Beach State Park? Stay tuned for the answer. The filming of Forrest Gump took place all across the city of Savannah and the Lowcountry. This includes the war scenes set in Vietnam, which were actually filmed at B, Hunting Island State Park.
For actor Gary Sinise, playing Lieutenant Dan changed his life in more ways than one. As WJCL 22 News' Lydia Blackstone explains, the research he gathered sparked a lifelong commitment in supporting our active duty military, our veterans, and their families.
Playing the character of Lieutenant Dan was more than a part to Gary Sinise.
That had a profound impact on me, just seeing all these wounded veterans who had really gone through what I kind of did, got paid to do, you know, pretending.
Instead, it created a lasting appreciation for the military and prompted him to create the Gary Sinise Foundation. His main focus, giving back to our nation's heroes.
The men and women serving our country know that I'm serious about supporting them.
Heroes like Ryan Davis, who lost three limbs overseas in service to the country. The Gary Sinise Foundation gifted the family a free home in Richmond Hill. Uniquely designed for them, every need met from wide hallways to a wheelchair ramp. WJCL 22 News was there last year when they first walked through the doors.
Did you ever watch the movie and think that you would be gifted a home by that man one day?
You know, I really didn't. It was one of my favorite movies growing up, obviously, like most people. But no, I had no clue that, you know, life works in such a way, right?
Since its founding, the Gary Sinise Foundation has also given over 1 million meals, 568 free concerts, and most famously, 92 accessible homes. And that's something that can change the course of life for a wounded warrior.
There's enough room on the side of my son's bed now to go all the way to him and give him a kiss goodnight.
The Davis House in Richmond Hill is just one example of what the foundation has done for military families.
And we spent a lot of time in the hospital, and he spent a lot of time checking in on us.
In February, Sinise's selfless and inspiring work was recognized during the Beaufort International Film Festival, when he was awarded the Pat Conroy Lifetime Achievement Award. 30 years after the filming of Forrest Gump, Sinise continues to uplift the voices and spirits of real-life Lieutenant Dans.
He's known for giving homes, but I'm most thankful for Gary's care of our family. He cares. And for that, that will what I remember about Gary long after his houses and his projects have moved on.
Lydia Blackstone, WJCL, 22 News.
From the Hostess City to the Lowcountry, we've covered a lot in the last half hour.
But if you'd like to learn more about this iconic film and its impacts, you can always visit our website, WJCL.com. From Historic Beaufort, I'm Riley Miller.
And I'm Shannon Royster. Thanks so much for joining us as we celebrate 30 years of Forrest Gump.